Hey, Cherry, how are you today?
Not good, Professor. Last night, a cockroach crept up to me and I'm still scared.
Oh, come on. Cockroaches are scared of humans and not vice versa, Cherry. A fan of superheroes and scared of a cockroach? That's not impressive at all.
No, I'm brave. But cockroach, they look so creepy, Professor.
If cockroaches are creepy, then what do you have to say about earthworms, Cherry?
Those slimy little things that crawl. Yuck! They are so slow and lazy. You can't even shoo them away.
Well, being slow doesn't make them lazy. A snail is also really slow in its movements, but that's how they are created, Cherry.
Snail, the one with a shell on its back.
Yes, that's correct. I must say though, I'm a bit surprised that you aren't a least bit curious to know about these creatures.
Actually, I am, Professor.
Well then, buckle up. The Sci-Fi Ride with Science for Juniors is here to answer all your questions.
Aren't we going to invite our friends for the ride, Professor?
Of course. Hi there, welcome to Science for Juniors. I am Dr. Oxy-Chan and this is my charming assistant, Cherry. Hop on, kids. The ride is about to begin. Let's begin the module with a race. Erdi, the earthworm, Eli, the snail, and Carrie, the cockroach, are in a race to beat each other. The track stretches from the tree till the exit gate of the park. Looking at the diversity of the participants, the run is going to be long and a tough one. Let's find out who wins the race in the module on earthworms, snail and cockroach, where we study movement in earthworm, movement in snail, movement in cockroach. The race is about to begin. Ready, steady and go! Is the competition amongst the unequals? Can't say as of now. Let's see how each of the trio move on the ground. In the first row, we have Erdi, the earthworm. An earthworm's body has many rings joined together. Its body is all muscles and no bones. A large number of tiny bristles connected to muscles project out from under its body. While the earthworm moves, it extends the front part of its body, keeping the rear end fixed to the ground with bristles. Then it fixes the front part, releases the rear end, and drags its rear end forward. Quite a coordinated effort. It needs to keep repeating such muscle contractions and relaxations so that our Erdi is able to move through the soil. Erdi could be a tough one to beat. In the second row, we have Eli, the snail. How can one think of carrying luggage on one's back while on the run? That too in a race. Is this the cause of the snail's pace? It's the shell on its back. Guess it can't do without, it's born with it. It goes wherever the snail goes. The best part is, the shell protects the snail's soft body. The snail has two tentacles. Do snails have feet? Yes, but where are they? Expectedly, underneath its body. This is one. Where is the other one? Oh, it has only one foot. The single foot is in the form of long muscular organ spread underneath its body. The muscles in the foot contract and expand to push our friend Eli the snail forward. A snail's pace might not be a safe bet when it comes to a race. Carrie the cockroach is in the third row. He looks pretty confident. Let's see what makes him move. The body of a cockroach is covered by a hard brown colored shell. A cockroach has legs in excess. Three pairs of legs for walking. These legs are connected by muscles to the body. Additionally, the Almighty has been kind enough to bless the cockroach with two pairs of wings as well. Wings? This means our Carrie can fly? Look, he's gone and already reached the winning post. The rules of the race were not clearly stated amongst the trio. Better luck next time.
That was an unfair race, Professor. Like I said, the cockroach is creepy and mean.
That was just an example, Cherry. Cockroaches are amazing creatures. Can you believe that a cockroach can remain alive up to 1 week without its head?
What? Without a head?
Amazing, isn't it? Now wait, weren't we talking about body movements? I got carried away again, didn't I?
I don't know.
Whatever the case, Science for Juniors is here to take us back to the topic of body movements. Are we all ears?
Yes, Professor.
The snail moves by creeping on a flat foot underneath its body. What are the silvery tracks left in the garden by a snail? The foot of a snail has special glands which produce slimy mucus to make a slippery track for easy movement. When the slime is released and it comes in contact with the air, it hardens to form a silvery track. Let us do an activity where we make a wormery. Let's take a large jar that has a wide opening. Add some soil and water. Now put some dead leaves, vegetable waste and earthworms in the jar. Place a paper bag over the top of the jar. This will keep out light but let the oxygen in. Keep the wormery in a damp area and keep an eye on the earthworms. You will observe the earthworms working in the soil. The earthworms can digest decaying parts and can also loosen the soil by their frequent movements in and out of the soil. This makes very good wormery compost, which is great plant nutrient and manure.
We have a nice garden outside our house. You think this wormery will help my mom in maintaining it?
You bet, Cherry. Your mom will be pleased to see you take interest in gardening. Hey, you can throw in some dead cockroaches as well. The earthworms will eat anything that's dead.
Oh, I'm too scared to find them, Professor. They're always hiding in the dark.
That's not entirely correct, Cherry. Science for Juniors will tell you why.
Let's challenge our brains to dodge the belief that cockroaches are afraid of light. Well, not exactly. While most species of cockroaches prefer darkness, some are actually attracted to light and can be found roaming near windows or on television screens at night. They scatter when light is shown upon them, and this reaction is more influenced by their fear of humans.
So you're saying they are afraid of us?
Well, I say it like I see it, Cherry.
Tell us more, Professor.
To begin with, do you know? The lifespan of a cockroach is just 1 year. Lucky cockroach gets to scare so many people in 1 year alone. But not all are so lucky. Only 20 species of the known 4,000 to 7,500 species of cockroaches are suited to live at home. That's a relief, isn't it, kids? Another interesting fact about cockroaches is that they die lying on their backs. That happens because they lose the ability to control their movements. With a bulky upper body, their thin leg muscles contract, pulling them beneath the body and causing it to tip over. But when alive, they are hard to catch as they can run up to 3 miles an hour.
No wonder we can never catch them.
Your hatred for cockroach is strong, Cherry.
I just don't like them, Professor.
Okay, relax. We are anyways at the end of the show. Let's quickly recap, shall we? In this module, we have learnt the following. An earthworm moves by repeating muscle contraction and relaxation. A large number of tiny bristles are present under the body of an earthworm. A snail moves with the help of a flat foot present underneath its body. A cockroach has three pairs of legs for walking and two pairs of wings for flying. So when do you start working on the wormery, Cherry?
As soon as possible, Professor. Where can I get the worms from?
Just look around in the garden, Cherry. You will find plenty in the soil.
Thanks, Professor.
You're welcome, Cherry. So, no more creepy cockroach talk, as it's that time again when we part ways only to meet again, same time, same place, for another interesting sci-fi ride. Right, Cherry?
Right!
So kids, till we meet again, take care and play safe.